Welcome back. Hope you are doing fine. We're going to talk about black medicine, brought to you by the Metal Gene. Look, it's a doctor coming. No wonder the image of someone dressed in white coat comes in mind, while deep down having hopes that the patient is going to get better. But it wasn't amazing that the image of a man dressed in black would be coming in mind of the people prior to 1889. Because similarly to executive, judiciary, and political activities, physician-patient interaction was considered as a serious and formal issue. The dressing code was black, since the black clothes were considered formal as today's tuxedo. Example, in 1875, there was the greatest American painting created by Thomas Eking with the title The Gross Clinic. The paint portrays a scene from Jefferson Medical Colleges in Philadelphia, showing Dr. Samuel Gross and his assistants carrying out a leg surgery. While they were all dressed in black, since by then the physicians dressed themselves in black, that's why even paintings, they appeared in black too. When did the white dressing in medical field begin? Until the 19th century, when the idea of antisepsis in surgery was taking hold in the world, specifically Europe, which was initiated by Joseph Lister, is where the movement began. This idea truly moved medicine from the home remedies and empiricism to the realm of bioscience. It also paved the way to understanding ways to prevent bacterial contaminations by emphasizing on cleanliness as the major way of overcoming sepsis. Since it was difficult to identify patches of blood that remained on doctors' black clothes, mainly after surgery, hence lots of contaminations, then the value of cleanliness and antisepsis had to be firmly fixed as the core of medicine or medical science. Thus, from then, doctors and other medical individuals appeared in white garbs. This is evident in the 1889 Thomas Eking painting entitled The Aging New Clinic, portraying a scene from the University of Pennsylvania, showing Dr. Hayes Aging New and his assistants all in white smock, while the nurse has a white cap. This suggesting that a new sense of cleanliness covered the environment. Although later, the white coloration in the medical field was attached to other beliefs such as hope and purity. Then, why nowadays in surgeries and other clinical settings, the meds are dressed in green or blue? Mnemonic store tells it all. One can say that it can be easy to differentiate the meds in their raw aspect. It can be right, but as a scientist, that's not enough. Come on, let's get it scientifically. According to an article, Issues on Today's Surgicalness of 1998 says that one influential doctor switched to green garbs because he thought it would be easier on a surgeon's eye. But can we say it's only that thought that made it global? I doubt that. But here are some few scientific reasons. Since the brain interprets colors relative to each other, then if a surgeon stares at something red, such as bloody organs, for some time, he or she becomes desensitized to it. Therefore, the red signal in the brain fades, which is likely to make it harder to see nicely the inside of the human body. But looking at something green or blue from time to time keeps someone's eyes more sensitive to variations in red. Therefore, looking at blue or green refreshes the surgeon's vision of redness during surgery. This is according to John Wenner, a psychologist who studied vision at the University of California, Davis. This brings us to point number two. Deep focus on red can lead to distracting green illusions on white surfaces. These green illusions could appear if a doctor shifts his gaze from the reddish body tissues to something white, such as white garbs, specifically of his or her assistants in the surgery room. These green illusions or distracting images would follow the surgeon's gaze wherever he looks, just similar to the floating spots we see after looking at day sun. This occurs because White light contains all the colors of the rainbow, including both red and green. But the red pathway is still tired out. So the red versus green pathway in the brain signals green. However, if a doctor looks at green or blue gaps instead of white ones, these disturbing green images will blend right in and not become a distraction anymore. This is according to Paola Bresson, who researches visual illusion at the University of Padova in Italy. Here is our last point. Not only that green has been scientifically found to lower a person's blood pressure, but it also gives the eyes a rest. You can refer to the project done by the California State Science Fair in 2003. On top of that, green has been the obvious choice to counteract headaches associated with looking at white gaps. Because green is the opposite of red on the color wheel, it helps ease surgeons' eye strain and it focuses their attention during surgery, whereby blue has a smoothing and relaxing and calming effect. Here is a conclusive fun fact. Did you know that the image of the white coat can lead to the white coat syndrome? What is white coat syndrome exactly? The term white coat syndrome is used to describe unrepresentative high blood pressure recordings due to a patient's anxiety upon seeing a doctor in a white coat. That's why majority of the pediatricians and psychiatrists generally choose not to wear the white coats in order to reduce anxiety of their patients. Hope you found this video useful and interesting. For more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe and turn on post notifications. But importantly, thumbs up by liking this video.